Everybody, welcome back to the Show and Tell Show with our friends over at Penetanguishene Centennial Museum, Nicole and Jan.
Hi.
And of course, Genevieve and I from Huronia Museum, broadcasting today from beautiful Central Springwater Township, where we both reside, now working from home. So our challenge this week was fancy things. And I know what Genevieve dragged out, but to see who goes first, why don't we have a curator throwdown with Nicole and Jan. Nicole and Jan, that makes no sense. Nicole and Genevieve. Okay. Rock, paper, scissors.
Okay.
Okay.
One, two, five.
Okay, you gotta go again.
Okay. 1, 2, 5.
Oh!
Scissors,
so I go first?
All right, Jenny, okay. What do we have?
I have two things to deal with the fancy work. One's the Modern Priscilla, which is a book full of, I guess, projects or ideas for the 1908 woman. Yes, so there were lots of projects that you could do, lots of different knitting and crochet and embroidery work. And I've got some examples here. This is an example of from one of the magazines. It's a crocheted collar. So you'll find projects like that. Very, very detailed work. Most of this work wasn't really necessary work. It was really to create ornamental items for your clothing or for your couches or for your walls, or there were all sorts of things. Pocketbooks for your handkerchiefs. These are, interestingly, if you can see them, these are, they use pieces of like ribbon or lace or tape. And then they tat around them to create little medallions that you could sew onto skirts or your blouses to embellish them. And we've got other examples of it right here. Here's the, I don't know if you can see this very well. There's the tapes right there. It's short lengths of the tapes, but then you can stitch them together to create flower decorative work, scroll work, that kind of thing. It's just a lot of really
nice,
interesting ways to personalize, I guess, your clothing and to ornament your blouses. Yes, make things fancy. That's right. So that was my fancy work.
And the tatting just looks so complicated. I just admire anyone who can do tatting.
Oh, it's beautiful.
All of those spools and
back and forth. Yeah. It's so fine.
Very good. Nice. Awesome. Okay.
Okay, what have you got over there at Penetanguishene Centennial?
All right, well, I'll introduce it. So this is one of our sort of proud Beck little artifacts that we have for the dandy man in your life.
The dandy man.
Yeah.
I don't have one of those.
Ooh. So just a little intro into it. So January the 15th, and of course you probably already know this, it's National Hat Day.
Of course.
We all knew that. So in 1797, on January the 15th, John Hetherington in London, England, was taken to court for going into public wearing this fancy item and scaring the bejesus out of everyone. So apparently women were screaming and fainting, children were crying, dogs were barking all over this one little hat. And he was actually given a 500-pound fine, which he paid and refused to stop wearing his lovely top hat.
I wouldn't stop wearing that either.
That's beautiful.
Yes. So this is actually an item that belonged to George Beck, who was a son of Charles and was born in 1887. And along with the hat, we have this wonderful, it's called an opera case. So you can see his initials on the top there.
Oh my goodness, that's wonderful.
So it's embossed and the case is leather. And inside are compartments. This is really a bit awkward. But this is an uppercase, and in there, you would be able to put all of your necessary items for going out for the opera. You have your gaiters for your shoes. And as well, we have, I'm not going to pop it up, but it's a collapsible top hat.
Oh!
So this one is not beaver felt, it's fabric. But I guess it was your, you know, your opera one. So, yeah.
If it rained outside, you don't want to get your beaver pelt wet, right?
No,
you don't. Certainly don't.
No.
Never.
No.
No, was he able to... Was he able to use that in Penetang?
Pardon me?
Was he able to use that in Penetang?
Well, see, there is
an opera house. Inside the
hat. Yeah.
Well,
okay.
Yeah, he's got his name inside here, and there's an address, but it doesn't say the town. I would think probably Toronto. He would have, you know, gone for a few days, taken the train or whatever, and yeah.
Oh,
that's awesome. That's an awesome hat.
That's beautiful.
Yes. Yeah.
That is awesome.
So, that's our fancy item for this week.
I'm actually really jealous of that hat. That's an amazing piece in your collection. That's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
Oh, and the opera box. That's amazing.
There's actually two little worn spots here and here, probably where he would grab it to lift it, to take it off.
Put it on.
There's just like a little worn spot, right?
Wore it a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
That's awesome. I love that. Okay, so I think it's our turn to challenge you.
Okay.
And I'm going to challenge you with a color this week.
Oh.
Okay, and this is a color because Nicole and I had this conversation about a certain color that is a part of my life. Anybody who knows me, it's a core part of my life. And
okay.
We talked about why I, yeah. I need you to find something. This is a twofer challenge actually next week. We got to find something black in our collection. Something black.
Mm-hmm.
And because next Friday is National Hat Day, we got to find a hat that we can wear. We got to show up
that we can wear. You want us to like be wearing it when we
come? You have to be wearing it. So it's not from the collection. It's a hat that you chose to wear for this.
Okay.
So you have to wear a hat, and we also have to bring something that's black.
Okie dokie. Because
I was going to say, a black and a hat, we've just already done that
Here we go. You know what? I was thinking about the color all week, and I'm like, okay, we're going to do the color thing. And then when she said hat day, I'm like, we got to wear a hat next week.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
Okay,
sounds
so
good.
That's it again for this week. We'll see everybody next week on the Show and Tell show, and thanks for joining us. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye.